संग कभी शुभल के संग, कभी श्री राम के संग कभी शुभल के संग, कभी मधुमंगल के संग मेरा केला
Yeah.
बंसी बारे अरे मंदिरों के दे दे हमारी कन्हैया बंसी बारे अरे मंदिरों के दे दे हमारी कन्हैया बंसी बारे अरे मंदिरों के दे दे हमारी कन्हैया बंसी बारे Yeah.
आपको बिटवीन गैलरी बिटवीन लेन बिटवीन टू माउंटेन वेरी नैरो पैसेज यू गो एंड देन यू विल सी दिस इज विष्णु पर्वत दिस साइड एंड दैट इज ब्रह्मा पर्वत I know that Brahma has done very hard austerity. Brahma ji ne bahut kathor tapasya ki. Ye kripa karke aapki leelaen hamare upar mein ho. Vishesh karke Shrimati ji ke saath mein jo raas leela, indol leela aur jo makkhan ityadi ki chori ityadi ki leelaen hamare upar mein kare. To theek hai. Tum Brahma parvat ho karke barshane mein aao. Yahan par Vishnu Bhanu Maharaj ji ka ghar hai. वहीं पर तुम ब्रह्म पर्वत बन करके आओ और वहीं पर श्रीमती जी के साथ में हमारी अत्यंत रहस्यपूर्ण प्रेममयी लीलाएं संपादित होंगी। ऐसा ही हुआ। इधर में ये विष्णु पर्वत कृष्ण के प्रतीक है, काले देखो यहाँ पर काला और इधर में कैसा गोरा पर्वत। दिस पर्वत इज लाइक गोल्ड कलर गोल्डन कलर एंड दिस mountain is like black color. It denotes Krishna and it denotes Srimati Radhika. In middle, there is a very narrow passage. A gali hai beech mein. Rishi ko kehte hain Shakari Kho. Shakari means very narrow. I think that it will be better that I will speak Hindi and he will speak. तो यहीं पर कृष्ण गोपियों से दान लेते थे किंतु यह दान साधारण जगत का दान नहीं, यह प्रेम का आदान प्रदान था, प्रेम का दान। इसलिए कभी गोपियों के साथ में ललिता जी विशाखा जी के साथ में श्रीमती राधिका जी कभी आ रही थी, कृष्ण ने उनका डगर रोक दिया, मार्ग रोक दिया और उनसे दान मांगा, उसमें रपट झपट हुई, उनमें परस्पर हाथाहाथी रपट झपट होने के बाद में कृष्ण ने ऊपर चढ़ करके और ठेले से उनके हड्डिया में मक्खन की हड्डिया में ठेला मारा और वो टूट गया और गोपी मक्खन से या दूध से स्नान कर लिया पूरा और सखा लोग ताली बजाने लगे। इधर में ललिता सखी जी ने कहा कृष्ण का रोज रोज की ये जो आदत है इसको दंड दे करके छुड़ानी चाहिए, इसलिए सखियों से मिल करके उन्होंने कहा कि ऊपर में वन में हम लोग छिप जाए और ललिता जी भीषण बजाएंगी और साथ ही साथ में उनके इशारे पर हजारों गोपियां एक साथ आकर कृष्ण को और उनके नटखट चेले चपाटियों को दंड दे।
Right now we have discussed that Krishna was throwing stone on pictures of gopis. In the continuation of same, Maharaji is saying that this place has got two mountains. One is of Vishnu and one is of Brahma. This is golden and this is black. In between there is a very very narrow passage. And how much is it narrow, we can realize when we'll pass through it. Hardly one person can pass from that passage. And such narrow passage is called Khol. And Sankari means narrow. So this is called Sankari Khol. So, when gopis used to pass from here with their pitcher on their head, and in that pitcher they were having butter or sometimes matha and milk like this, so Krishna will come and forcefully stop the passage. Dagar rok lete the. Dagar means passage. Rok lete the. Now you have heard the song, it also says that gopis are saying, why are you stopping our passage? Rasta rok lete the, they used to stop the passage and will say that give us tax. Hindi, their word, they are using it dan. Dan does not mean tax. Dan means charity. As if the Krishna is biggest pandit and priest over here, and he requires donation and charity from everyone. Forceful charity he used to ask for, and gopis used to refuse for it. And then there is Hathabai. Maharaj is saying there is Hathabai, tussle with hand. Lapat jhapat. So, when gopis are not ready to give, he will come at some distance, put some pebbles and throw over those pitchers. Pitcher will break, and all the curd, milk, buttermilk and butter will fall on Radharani and gopis. Once gopi had an assembly that Krishna disturbs us like this so much time, we should teach him a lesson. So we should take a revenge and teach him a lesson. So what did they do? They planned lakhs of lakhs gopis. They just spread it all over this place in hiding manner and said that some gopis will pass from here with Radharani, and Krishna will be very happy with his sakha that today Radharani is nearly alone. And the moment he will come and will break the pitcher, we will all come and catch him. But how will they come? Lalita became the head leader of this whole gang leader of this activity, Leela. She will just give a whistle, and the moment she will give whistles, all gopis will attack on Krishna and his friends. The same happened when Radharani with her friends, a few friends, not much. This is called baiting process. I think when we catch some birds, we throw some bait, B-A-I-T. They came as bait. And all the sakhas came, and they forcefully tried to catch the pitchers of Radharani and other gopis. At that time, Lalita just gave a whistle, and thousands of gopis, they came fastly, and they caught each and every sakha of Krishna, gop of Krishna, and they started giving gulcha on the cheeks of all those sakhas. Gulcha means boxing, punching. Boxing is something different thing. Punching is punch, heavy punch. And all they took their shikha and they bind their shikha with the branches of trees. And all sakhis then caught Krishna. You are the gang leader. You have to be taught the real lesson. And they brought a lehenga, a choli and a chunariya for him. They forcefully put on lehenga and choli and chunari and some decoration on their face, just like a very beautiful girl, and then a very big pitcher on their head full of buttermilk, butter, and then you just move from here. And he was forced to move. At that time some gopis stood little distance and threw pebbles on that pitcher, and pitcher was broken and all yogurt fell on him, and that was Abhishek of Krishna and God Premanande. All the gopis were clapping like this.
Around gentlemen.
You do it again.
Never do like this. Otherwise again.
Now they took a vow from Krishna and from his sakha that you give a promise that you will never do this thing. And Krishna was forced to give this promise that he will never do
promise
it.
Promise like this. I
don't know whether this is the thing in India, if someone has to give a punishment, then he is asked to catch his
ears.
I don't know whether in Western countries this is a thing, but here, Toba Kanal, I will never do it, and he will catch his ear that I did my mistake. And another extension of the punishment. Vishakha said, Lalita has taken a bow and I will take a stamp on it. What is the stamp? You catch your ear and do put her, sit and get up.
Ten times.
In Hindi it is called uthak baithak. Sit down, get up, sit down, get up, sit down, get up.
You saw.
Also, just to listen one thing.
then that grihastha brings so much milk or butter or ghee and they give here.
The distributor
here. चढ़ाते हैं and they offer here their milk, first milk of that cow or buffalo. They give here. Here you can see where Krishna kept his lathiya here to run away from hands of gopi and his pagadi गिर गई, उनकी पगड़ी गिर गई और उसकी चिन्ह वहाँ पर है.
When Krishna, when gopis chased Krishna and Krishna ran from here, his stick fell down and his turban also fell down.
So this there is a
symbolical impression is over there.
You can go now very carefully, otherwise you can fell down. चित्रा जी का जन्म हुआ था. चित्रा जी समस्त
कलाओं में निपुण थी। वे अत्यंत सुंदर चित्रकारी बनाती थी, मानो अब केवल बोलना बाकी रह गया कितना सुंदर कृष्ण का चित्र बना सके। राधा जी को देखा, इस तरह से सांपों का मंत्र जानती थी, पक्षियों की बोली समझती थी, रसोई में एकदम एक्सपर्ट थी, बड़ी कला निपुण। घरों में जो चित्रकारियां होती हैं उसमें भी निपुण, इसलिए जितनी ऐसी शक्तियां थी उनका ये हेड बनाया था चित्राशक्ति। उनके माता पिता यहीं पर पासी में रहते थे, उन्हीं के घर में उनका जन्म हुआ था। दिस प्लेस इज शिक्षौली ग्राम आफ्टर द नेम ऑफ चित्राशक्ति। द फादर एंड मदर जस्ट टू लिव इन दिस विलेज शिक्षौली एंड वी आर इन अ वेरी रेस्ट्रिक्टेड फैमिली ऑफ गो जबकि एक समय की बात, राधा जी बड़ी अपने शक्तियों से कही, अब मैं प्राण धारण नहीं करूंगी, अब तो अब मैं मरना ही चाहती, मैं कहीं सरोवर में कूद करके या बीच खा करके जैसे अब अपने प्राण प्राप्त कर लें। I don't want to keep my life, I want at once to die. Why? I got so much Pati Pratarna, I was chastened, but now I'm not chastened. मैं पति प्रधान नारी थी, आज हमारा यह व्रत खत्म हो गया, इसलिए आज तो जरूर मरना है। क्यों, क्या हो गया? ललिता जी ने पूछा। What happened? Oh, I heard a flute call very sweet, and I gave heart to that person who was playing on. मैंने अपना हृदय उस बंसी वाले के प्रति दे दिया, सदा के लिए मैं बेच दिया अपने को, जो सुंदर बंसी बजाया और उसकी बंसी की तान सुन करके अब अपनी रही नहीं। इतने में किसी ने कृष्ण नाम सुनाया, कृष्ण नाम सुनते ही मैंने उस कृष्ण को अपना हृदय दे दिया, ये दूसरे और तीसरे ने एक चित्र दिखलाया, चित्रा जी ने बहुत सुंदर फोटो चित्र दिखलाया और मैंने अपने को उसको सरेंडर कर दिया, अब हमारे तीन हो गए। आप पति प्रता है, अरे जिसने बंसी बजाया उसी का नाम कृष्ण है और उसी कृष्ण का ये चित्रा जी ने चित्र आपको बना करके दिया है, तीनों एक ही दिने ऑफ द दैट पर्सन हु वाज प्लेइंग ऑन द रोड, सेम पर्सन एंड हिज नेम इज सेम कृष्ण एंड द फोटो ऑफ दैट बॉय फ्लैश इज द सेम।
Thank you. stones. When we came first, about 54 years before with our Guruji, there was no pakka anything. Mayur Kuti was there, where Krishna and Radhika danced in the form of peacock. Also, here, lower down, there are so many groves. Anyone can hide in that. Srimati Radhika used to hide here and Krishna to search here and there. Uh-huh. At last, by the signal of
Chitra
or Vishakha, Krishna was Krishna anyhow searched Srimati Radhika. So there are so many groves here and there. Upside on this top of this hill is Bilasgarh. In very childhood, Srimati Radhika used to play with dust like homes, making homes like this. And sometimes Krishna used to meet there. Sometimes Radhika was playing with dust with all the sakis. A storm came and all the dust began to fly here and there. In the meantime, everywhere it was like dark, and anyhow Krishna came black and anyone could not see. And he met there Srimati Radhika. So this is called Vilaskund. There are so many places, pastimes, sweet pastimes on Vilaskund. Here also we will see Dangarh. This is called Vilasgarh. Here is Mangarh. And at last we will go to
Dangarh.
We will tell the story there, how it is became Dangarh. We are now going to Govardhan. All the Goswamis, so many great rishis, used to come to this place and to do austerities here, to have the mercy of Srimati Radhika Devi. Also Krishna used to come and meet with Gopi. We will narrate these histories upward. Gaur Pramanande.
Mayur Koti ka thoda sa bata.
Govinda Jai Jai Gopal Jai Jai Govinda.
हम लोग गवर्नमेंट की परिक्रमा करते हुए इस स्थान पर आए हैं। अब राधा जी का मंदिर भी खूब अधिक दूर नहीं, यहाँ से दान महल और दान महल से पार करके हम लोग श्रीमती जी के कुंज में या उनके मंदिर में हम लोग पहुंचेंगे। नाउ वी आर coming to this place is in Gahwarban. We have gone to Morkoti. We have told about Vilasgarh. We have told about Mangarh. This is a part of Mangarh. Also you can see Srimati Radhika anyhow became so worried. He had heard from his parrot, she parrot, that Krishna has met with Chandrauli, and he was pacifying Chandrauli. So hearing this, she became so sulky and in anger mood.
Upset.
She promised, उसने ये प्रतिज्ञा की, काले चीजों से अब हमारा कोई संबंध नहीं है. I have no connection with any black person. I will not take
is sari dhoti which border is black. I have no connection with any black. She also covered her black hair with white cloth. Anyhow, she was not in a mood to Krishna se sandhi karne ke mood mein nahi thi. She was not in a mood to compromise with Krishna. One day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days went on. Krishna became so puzzled. And he wanted to meet with Srimati Radhika. By inner, she also wanted to meet Krishna. But outwardly, by the fear of Lalita, she had no dare to meet with Krishna, because Lalita had told, Dhurte Brijandatane Tan Srushta Bhamna. Don't be very easy for Krishna. Be very crooked. If Krishna wants to meet, you should be like this. And you should go. So today Shivas has so very powerful mind. Anyhow, it was not coming down. Then Krishna was waiting. She went in the Sharaname, shelter of Sri Vishakha Devi. Vishakha Devi told that you will have to do like this. You can come with any very qualified Mohini, Shyama Sakhi. And then you can try. So Subal Sakha made Krishna a very beautiful Kishori lady. उन्होंने उसको सजा दिया. उस समय में ऐसा मालूम पड़ता था ये राधिका के अतिरिक्त उनसे कोई ब्रज में सुंदरी नारी नहीं. She became so beautiful, sweet lady that it was not less than Harshad Srimati Radhika. She took some flowers and she told that I am Malini, Shyama Malini, daughter of a gardener. She was so expert in making garlands. She told that if I will give my garland to anyone who is so worried, is so tired, anyhow, then she will be out of time. Everything will go and he will be so happy, or she will be so happy. They brought to Srimati Radhika, where she was feeling so much mad and anger, not eating, drinking anything. Seeing that Shyama Sakhi, Malini, oh, how beautiful she is, and how she is expert. She made a garland so in art that Srimati Radhika was moved, and she began to usko माने उसके आर्ट की प्रशंसा करने लगे. Then Vishakha told, oh, she is very qualified in all arts. If she will touch you, your all tiredness and all your anger man will go away. Oh, I will see, bring her. So when she came and touched Srimati Radhika, by touching Srimati Radhika, I realized that, oh, she is not any Malini or Shyama Sakhi. She is Shyam, not Shyama. And he at once brought a click there. उसने उसके मन में राधा जी के मन में कुछ भावना आई. Made a plan, trick. Thank you.
bucket.
We need a bucket, mate. Give me.
What?
Lemon juice.
Please, a bucket for the lemon juice. Maharaj,
you're going to get it? Yes, I'm going to get it.
Nityananamastibhyam Premananapadayane Kalakamasanashaya Janavapati Namaha. To glorify Srila Prabhupada is not an easy thing to do. It says with material senses we cannot chant the holy name, see Krishna. We need spiritual transcendental senses. So I'm unqualified to properly glorify such a personality of Srila Prabhupada. The spiritual master, the pure devotee, is not one of this world. He is Gaura Priyajana, Arada Priyasaki, a dear girl companion from the spiritual world. We say there's 10 offenses to chanting of the holy name to get Chudanam. Unless we cross beyond the Nam Abhas, Nam Aparad, these 10 offenses, and we all repeated the 10 offenses many times, and one might say, what is the worst offense of the 10 offenses? Usually we think to blaspheme a guru or pure devotee is the most serious crime in the offenses, and it is. But because the spiritual master is an ocean of mercy, it is said that the ornament of the Vaishnava is his forgiveness. He can forgive us, but even a more severe offense is to consider the pure devotee an ordinary person. So Srila Prabhupada, it's not that he perfected his sadhana and he was a pure devotee. He is coming down from the spiritual world, like all our Guru Varg. His love for his spiritual master, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, knew no bounds. So his whole life was one of preparation. But just like in Gaur Leela, everything Mahaprabhu did was a pastime in itself. So Srila Prabhupada's so-called difficult in household life, etc., was to teach us. There was no obstacle at all in his life. It was for our own learning. Because he is not one of this world. He has come down. He is a dear companion of Srimati Radhika. I've heard devotees say that Prabhupada was not of that character, and it's very sad to hear such things. Because if one actually does not understand that the pure devotee is coming down from the higher world, it's very hard, difficult to make advancement. And to hear the Hare Katha from such a pure devotee is about our only hope. Really, what sadhana, at least for myself, what sadhana can we do? So the only hope is to hear the pure Hare Katha from the lips of a pure devotee of such a caliber. There's a story that you heard, but some of you might not have heard it, and I'll just say it again, that when Srila Prabhupada came, this was narrated to a godbrother of mine, who someone told him, that Prabhupada told him in confidence, that when he came over on the Jaladut, he had a couple heart attacks, and he said that he prayed to Krishna to relieve him of his pain. The Prabhupada told this devotee, it was Vishvambhara Goswami, father of Padmanabha Goswami, who told this devotee, told me, Prabhupada didn't want anyone to know this. He said, please don't tell anybody. But after Prabhupada left, this devotee couldn't keep it in his heart anymore, and he had to say that when Prabhupada had that heart attack, said Krishna personally came and massaged his chest. So it was all a plan, Krishna's plan, and Saraswati Thakur's plan. Prabhupada was picked to do such a mission. So these dear associates of Krishna are very, very rare. We sing every day, Sri Guru Charna Padma, that the lotus, let the lotus grow in our hearts. Now what is that lotus? It is the Bhakti Ras. Another name for rasa, there's many names for rasa. One is water. So where does the lotus grow? The lotus grows in the water. So that lotus of love, that bhakti rasa, grows in the heart of the Vaishnava, of the aspiring devotee. And by hearing the Hare Katha from the lips of a pure devotee, one can advance further and further. In Kali Yuga, it's very difficult, especially for Westerners. It is said that Jagai and Madhai were so fallen, but I can personally attest they were angels compared to myself. And I know that. So sometimes you see a spider and just a string is hanging from a spider web. The only thing that I'm hanging on to is Prabhupada's mercy. I can't do proper sadhana, I can't do anything. So I prayed to Prabhupada very much what to do, and it became very, very clear and evident to come to Srila Narayan Maharaj. Some things I can't really say now, but it's a very, very deep, deep feeling, and very deep things came to me. A few years ago, when I met Srila Narayan Maharaj, he said, never leave me and I'll never leave you. And that same feeling, when you used to look in Prabhupada's eyes and sit in front of Prabhupada, Prabhupada emanated that same feeling within one's heart, that he promised that if we continued our service to him and our love for him, he'll never leave us. And that same feeling, that same heartfelt feeling is there with Srila Gurudev. So Srila Gurudev asked how we came to Krishna consciousness, so-called. In fact, I really haven't come yet. I'm just starting, trying to come. And so many things are being revealed more and more by Srila Gurudev. But to make a long story short, in 1968, I went to a festival. They used to call them lovins. And the devotees were there chanting. And I saw they were quite unique. I never saw devotees before. I was quite young, very young at that time. And they handed me a card to come to a Sunday feast. And because that evening I was quite hungry, I went to the feast. And there I bought the old purple Bhagavad Gita, picture of Prabhupada in the back. I looked at that picture and I thought, what an amazing person this person is. So beautiful. And so for those 4 years, I tried to read, but I was quite young. So in 1971, I was going to college, and a few friends that you might know, Tripurari Swami and a few others, were living in a house, and Prabhupada came to Los Angeles for the first time, and we all drove down. It seemed like yesterday, actually. And we came to see Prabhupada, and that was it. Love at first sight. So, sometimes in a race, you see in a relay race, when someone is passing the baton to the next person, the race must go on. So I feel in my heart that Srila Prabhupada wanted so much for us to proceed. And in his last days, he took Gurudev's hands, and he knew what he wanted, but he had to say it in a very certain way. And as that baton was being passed to the next runner, Prabhupada has lovingly passed on his heart and his mission to Srila Gurudev. One last thing I want to say that was kept quite very quiet in Prabhupada's last days. In 1977, in September, he was in India and he was going to America. He wanted to see his disciples for the last time. The doctor told him if he went to the West, he might get better. I happened to be in England then, and they asked me to guard Prabhupada's door. Upendra Prabhu was Prabhupada's personal servant. And after a few days, Prabhupada got very, very sick. And so Upendra asked me, Devendranath, come in the room and help me. I can't take care of Prabhupada myself. He can't get out of bed. So Prabhupada got worse and worse, so-called worse, by the day. And then he called the secretary in and said, we're going back. And his secretary said, where are we going? Prabhupada said, we're going back to Vrindavan. So Prabhupada was only going to stay a week, but it ended up staying 3.5 weeks. And Prabhupada got quite ill, and Prabhupada's mood was very different. He wasn't speaking, he was very quiet. He had to wear glasses, and we had to carry him in a little palanquin. And it was a very moving experience because he didn't have to say a word. And one day, we thought he was going to leave at that time, so we took him to the hospital. And it's not so good to talk about this, but it's a very, I think, important point. It's been kept quiet. So at the hospital, Prabhupada had a minor operation, but he didn't care if he lived. He was ready to leave right then because he was always in Vrindavan. And he said, do whatever you like with me. So as they did the operation, I was watching the operation, and then the nurse took Prabhupada out of the room, and I helped her carry. The bed was quite big, and I helped her take the bed down the corridor, and I looked at Prabhupada, and his head was tilted back. I had to look down because Prabhupada was in physical, his physical pain was great. And I felt it was because of his disciples like myself that couldn't carry on properly what he actually wanted. So his dear friend and associate, eternal associate, Srila Gurudev, Prabhupada has heartfully passed on his mission. The mission goes on in many ways, but when you have a magnifying glass, you might see certain things that are more prominent. And as Gurudev says, we should never criticize. So let whatever others do. But we are following someone who's so sweet and dear to Srila Prabhupada that our fortune is so great. And I pray that Srila Gurudev bless me that I can continue.
Sripad Brajendranandan Prabhu should glorify his Gurudev.
Hare Krishna.
नमः ओम विष्णु बुधाय कृष्ण प्रसाय बुधाय श्रीमती भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी की नमः नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणि पुछारिणे निर्वशिष्ट सिंधुवारी पुछारिणे सितारे नमः ओम विष्णु बुधाय राधिकाय प्रियात्मने श्री श्रीमद् भक्ति वेदांत नारायण की नमः वंशकल्पतरूपश्च कृपसिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः. I have mixed feelings coming in front of everyone. I'm in this association feeling quite intimidated and unworthy, but at the same time, because of the eternal debt I have to Srila Prabhupada, I want to say something to glorify my spiritual master. Not too long ago, I read something in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. It was a purport by His Divine Grace, and it was very timely for me. I had been praying about 2 years ago for quite a long time because of my fallen condition to properly understand and appreciate Srila Prabhupada, because I didn't. I am too much of a beginner in this life and very little adhikara. And praying and praying and praying for such a long time. And then Srila Gurudev comes to Badger, California, somewhere in the middle of nowhere, and begins to explain to us in a very deep way who our Srila Prabhupada is and what he wants from us. So without that, I wouldn't even attempt to begin to speak here tonight. But somehow or other, by the grace of Srila Prabhupada, I've been placed in the care of his dear friend, Rasik Vaishnava Srila Gurudev, who is helping me to have some hope in this wretched life. This purport that I read shortly after Gurudev's arrival, it was in the story of Shivananda Sen in the Antya Lila of the Chaitanya Charitamrita. And Shivananda Sen had befriended this dog on his travels, and by the grace of the association of Shivananda Sen, the dog then got the association of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and as Prabhupada explains, that dog went back to Godhead. And in this purport, Prabhupada spoke so beautifully. First, he commented that one has to become the dog of a Vaishnava. For about 40 years, I've had no trouble being a dog, but to be a dog of a Vaishnava is no light thing. And Prabhupada's words were so powerful as he expresses that point there. And then he goes on to explain that his father, Gaur Mohande, who was a pure devotee, prayed that Srila Prabhupada would one day become the servant of the eternal consort of Lord Krishna. Because Gurudev had been indicating the proper understanding of Rupanuga, being a Rupanuga Vaishnava, and there had been so much speculation about Srila Prabhupada, this and that, reading that purport was so reinforcing for me, as well as the katha, the Harikatha that was coming from Srila Gurudev, that I began to see Prabhupada and Srila Gurudev working co-jointly in my life to lift me from what is Prabhupada called the mire of material existence. And then Prabhupada went on to explain that we have to, even if one is wretched and fallen, if he gets the favor of a pure Rasik Vaishnava, then the same mercy can come to him as to someone who is very advanced in taking shelter of a pure devotee. So, knowing my own background, there seems to be some competition tonight as to who is the greatest dog. I don't know who was, but I know I was definitely in one of the breeds. Srila Prabhupada, I first saw him in 1968. I was a college student. He came to speak at my university. I was too fallen to come to the precincts of Krishna consciousness. But I never forgot. I had no idea that I was meeting my eternal divine master. But somehow or other, there was some respect and appreciation there. In the middle of this 60s turmoil of illicit sex, intoxication, very calmly he speaks to us and says, no illicit sex, no intoxication, no gambling. I knew there was something of substance there, but I wasn't able to accommodate it fully in my heart. And then about 2 years later, when I became materially exhausted, all my aspirations for dog life were finished, I came to the temple and I immediately joined or stayed at the temple, lived, and I started following the four regulative principles, chanting 16 rounds. And after about 6 months, I accepted Harinam from Srila Prabhupada. But my conditioning and my low nature were still manifesting. When it was time for reach for the beads, I reached with my left hand. And Srila Prabhupada pulled back. And with affection, but with like, who is this person, a little bit of that, then he gave me the beads in my right hand. And then on another occasion shortly after that, some reason he looked at me. I never had much association direct with Prabhupada. These were just the few moments. And for some reason he wanted a madangar at the kirtan. And I was so clumsy and adept, he just happened to look at me and he said, where's the madanga? And I immediately panicked and started shaking everybody in the temple. Where's the madanga? Where's the madanga? And then on another occasion, I went to Mayapur, and in the evening I was guarding Prabhupada's quarters. This is just to tell you what Prabhupada had to deal with, and yet how merciful he was. And it was in the evening, and Prabhupada had to go to the restroom. So I ran down in front of the bathroom, and I stood there with a stick like this, waiting for Prabhupada to come out with the stick. And Prabhupada walked out, and what is this? You are guarding? Yes, Prabhupada, like that. And he just started laughing. And he looked up and he said, what is he guarding? Like this. So even though I was a fool and a wretch, somehow or other, I was allowed to engage in his service. And because he accepted that service, I never cared for anyone in my life before, but we distributed books, we lived in a van, we went out in the snow, we went out in the subways, car to car, in the blistering hot sun. But because Prabhupada said, distribute my books, we performed all these austerities, and we were happy. And little glimpses of Vraj, as we would read the Krishna book at night, would manifest causelessly in our heart, just by our connection with him. No other reason, no other adhikar. As one of my friends once said, Srila Prabhupada, you are our only opulence. And I think that prayer, Gurudev, it says, your mercy is all that I am made of. So after some time, for whatever reason, the fire of service waned. And pride, offenses, anarthas came up. And again, Purna Musaka Bhav. So many years of torment and anxiety, speculation, fear, and then, as I mentioned, the prayers, please help me again to properly understand and serve Srila Prabhupada. And then Srila Gurudev arrived, and my life now has hope. So I want to take this occasion, in Varshana, as Prabhupada said, somehow or other, he said in this purport, I become the eternal servant of the consort of Sri Krishna. So here in Varshana, in the association of another eternal servant of the consort of Sri Krishna, who has given me his shelter, and in the association of some of his pots without holes, I, with ever little sincerity I have in my heart, want to beg you to please tolerate me, please accept me, and to please allow me to no longer be a dog, but to be the dog of a Vaishnava.
They think that my Gurudev loves me much more.
I heard from all the disciples of Prabhupada Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. All used to tell that he used to love me so much. Also, I have seen our Gurudev. I used to know that Gurudev loves me more than anyone. But here we are so many, still, like Nikunja, like Vaishnava Maharaj, they think that he used to love them more than me also. He used to tell, Nikunja Prabhu. So this formula also goes to Swamiji. Anyone who has came to him, whether he is disciple or not, especially if he is disciple of Swamiji, he must know that, he used to love me so much more than anyone. So his specialty was like this. Everyone, he is a smiling face, even to a child, he will try to play with a child, a smiling. And when he will be with very learned person, he will be very great. Like the President of India then was very learned person, biggest Mayavadi, Dr. Radha Krishna. Then he used to be very great. And cutting their all arguments, Mayavadi, in a very easy way. It was very easy for them. But I know this thing, that he wanted to mix with general persons. He went to colleges, he went to very big doctors and philosophers and all, but not so much. He wanted to mix with general person and to preach in a very general way, in a very simple way, all these things. That we are mortal, every suffering, sorrow, birth and death, especially in old age, and we should try to serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is Krishna. We are Christian, he used to tell. We are Christian, but what Christian? Refined or what? Real Christian, reformed or real Christian. He used to tell that his office was in Bombay. His sadhana place is in Mayapur. And his eternal abode is in how he fixed all this. He used to tell that there is a lame person and another is blind person. We Indian, lame person having eyes, strong also. And Western, they are blind, knowing nothing but in spirituality. So they are blind. But they have so much money and everything. वो इस चीज को कहा करते थे जो भारतवासी जो भक्त लोग हम लोग हैं यहाँ के लोग लंगड़े हैं वहाँ के लोग अंधे हैं दोनों मिलकर के हम चल सकते हैं वी कैन वॉक हेल्पिंग ईच अदर ब्लाइंड पर्सन can carry, and lame person can come on the shoulder. And he will direct the way. Though is it not a true fact in all, माने संपूर्ण रूप में ये संपूर्ण रूप में नहीं है, जागतिक रूप में है. हाँ, तो भी वो ठीक है. भक्त जो होता है वो लंगड़ा नहीं होता है. जो मुकुंद का भजन करता है वो किसी कारणी नहीं होता, वो किसी चीज की कमी नहीं उसमें होती है, वो संपूर्ण रूप से पूर्ण होता है. The devotees are purna. They don't need not help anything. But for material world, for preaching, wealth is also somewhat necessary. But it is not so much essential if our heart is true, sincere, and devoted to his Lord and his Gurudev. And he is a very big, बहुत दृढ़ संकल्प, वेल डिटरमाइंड, देन वेल्थ एंड एवरीथिंग विल कम. सो ही वाज डिटरमाइंड, ही वाज फिक्स्ड इन हिज ऑब्जेक्ट. दैट इज व्हाई ही वेंट टू इंग्लैंड, अमेरिका, एंड वेरी इजीली ही कॉट द हार्ट्स ऑफ ऑल डिवोटीज. He made happy two hippies. Who were hippies? He made them happy. Once he was telling that when he was in New York, on that tree and that park, and he used to begin his movement only alone in that park, sitting there. अन और करता श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवास आदि शिव, क्लोजिंग हिज आईज लाइक समाधि एंड डूइंग कीर्तन. हु इज हियर नॉट हियर, हु इज हियरिंग नॉट हियरिंग, नो माइंड, कोई भी परवाह नहीं. और हिप्पी लोग वो सब जंत्र लेकर के, एक तारा और क्या क्या लेकर के उनको घेर करके रखते, नित्य करते. They used to dance when he used to sing, and they used to give him wine. Oh, we are very happy, so you should also take this. He did not hate them. And after some time, so many hippies, very young personalities, boys and girls, they came and they took initiation, and thus in a very short time everywhere in the world he preached so much. तो उनके संबंध में बहुत कुछ कहना है. I want to tell something more. And in the class here, after aarti, we will see it again. I am requesting all to come there. Just after aarti and parikrama, we will sit there and we will hear so many sincere and senior Vaishnavas. I think there are so many, and we will hear, and also I will also try to tell so many things in connection. What were connection with me, and how he attacked me, and how I served him. I did not serve him, he took my service. So now Mand Kirtan should be done, and after that we will go to aarti, and after, just after aarti, we should all come, and then again we will glorify you.
Thank you.